Hello, my name is Eyþór Eðvarðsson, and I'm one of the crew who's going to row across the Atlantic Ocean from Norway to Iceland this summer. And on our way, we will stop at different places and tell about the story that Iceland and the relationship that Iceland has with those countries, Norway, the Orkney Islands, Faroe Islands. And therefore, I have Gisli Sigurðsson, professor at Árnastofnun in Iceland, with me today. And he's going to tell us about those historical links between Iceland and Norway. Gisli, the historical connections between Iceland and Norway.
Iceland was first settled from Norway during the reign of King Harald Fairhair. Before that, people had been here from the British Isles, the Irish monks, Irish hermits, perhaps with some working servants with them. Mm-hmm. And this was in the early Viking Age, the late 9th century, and during that time, the chieftains, male chieftains, were coming directly from Norway in an organized effort. Mm-hmm. And many of them then made a stopover in the Norse colonies in the British Isles. Some came directly from there, or else they bought slaves or got married even to local Gaelic women and brought them with them to Iceland. So the first population of Iceland, if we leave aside the Irish monks, yeah, was dominated by Norwegian males coming both from Norway and the Norse colonies in the British Isles.
Okay.
And they brought with them the language that was dominated in Iceland, the what we call Icelandic, but the Norwegians call Norse, and the wider world calls Old Norse. And this is the language that was used for the writing of all the sagas, all the history of the Viking world that was recorded based on oral tradition in Iceland much later, in the 12th and 13th centuries.
Yeah. Icelanders wrote a big part of the Norwegian history, didn't they?
Yes, that was how they, I think, wrote themselves into the culture of the neighboring countries. They made a name for themselves, the people of Iceland, very early on. Again, perhaps because of influence from the Gaelic world, where the verbal art was very strong, the art of poetry, the art of storytelling on a professional level. The people of Iceland got that tradition into their own culture and exported it immediately to Norway on a professional basis. Court poets in Norway almost exclusively came from Iceland. They had positions and they could charge a certain amount of the money for the praise poems that they would compose and perform at the courts. And this later then developed into a great interest in the royal historiography of Norway and Denmark and other countries as well. And the writers in Iceland in the 13th century, they could write a collection of king sagas, and the Heimskringla by Snorri Sturluson is by far the best known of these works. Snorri laid the foundation for the modern Norwegian state in creating and defining the idea of the Norwegian kingdom through the stories he told. It is often said that events don't become great until someone tells the story about them. So it's the story about reality that makes the events we experience great as they are. And the notion of the great Norwegian kingdom is created in the writings of Icelanders and culminates in the writing of a great codex in the late 14th century Flateyja book, where people gather all the king sagas from Norway in a huge book, adding on sagas about people from Iceland, people from Orkney, people from the Baltic Sea and Greenland, Vinland, and the entire world known to the Vikings during the Viking Age.
Excellent. This is a big history, isn't it?
This is a huge history and extraordinary literary achievement for the people of Iceland, remote island, to write the history of the neighboring countries and in particular what we are looking at, the notion of the Norwegian kingdom, because later on the we had an independent state in Iceland for some centuries, but gradually the Norwegian king became more influential, first through the missionary activity, through the official Christianization of the country around the year 1000, and later through political alliances in the 13th century, gradually leading up after a civil war in Iceland to Icelandic chieftains accepting the Norwegian king as their ruler in 1262 to 64.
Okay, we could talk for a long time, Gisli. This is short history of Iceland and Norway. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.